Welcome to the Colchester Sixth Form College 2020 Induction Audio Interactive PowerPoint. Each of the slides explains a different aspect of A-level electronics. The audio track on each slide will take you up to about a minute to listen through. If you have any further questions, please email Mark at the address shown on the first slide.
Why study A-level electronics? Electronics is a practical subject with immediate relevance to many aspects of contemporary science and technology. This subject will help you to develop scientific knowledge and conceptual understanding of the behavior of analog and digital electrical electronic circuits, including a wide range of electronic components. Electronics will help you to develop an understanding of the nature, processes, and methods of electronic as an engineering discipline to help answer questions about practical circuits. Electronic will also help you to be aware of new and emerging technologies, to develop and learn how to apply problem-solving skills, to identify needs in the world and to design and test electronic solutions.
What qualifications do I need to get onto the electronics course? The minimum entry criteria are standard college entry requirements as detailed in the prospectus, grade 5 in GCSE mathematics, and either grade 6 for both first and second grade GCSE combined science, or if triple science is taken, or grade 6 in GCSE physics, ideally also with 6 in either GCSE biology or chemistry. Please note that GCSE applied science qualifications are not acceptable as alternative science qualifications for electronics A level.
What does the syllabus cover? We work through topics in the order of the online textbook chapters, including logic systems, operational amplifiers, and microcontrollers in year one, and signal conversion, digital communication, and high power switching systems in year two. Each of the topics is resourced on the College Interactive Learning System. There are detailed notes, examples, and questions for everything. To master electronics, you will need to look at how components work together in circuits and how circuits can be grouped together to form systems. We consider how problems in the real world can be solved by specifying systems in terms of how input signals are to be processed to produce desired outcomes. Each of the components, circuits, and systems we look at can be analysed in one of four ways. Firstly, as a circuit symbol or diagram. Secondly, by a graph showing output plotted against input. We call that a characteristic. Thirdly, using a mathematical formula or formulae. And fourthly, by a verbal description using technical terms.
How is A-level electronics taught? Circuits and techniques are introduced using working demonstration circuits, live wire simulations, and PowerPoint presentations, alongside class discussion sessions, quizzes, and group work. There is individual and sometimes collaborative practical work. Homework is set and marked regularly. There are fully equipped workstations with test equipment and digital oscilloscopes.
So how will my work be assessed, you might be asking? So 80% of the final marks are awarded from two exam papers, 2 hours and 45 minutes each. Component one is principles of electronics worth 40%, and the second component is applications of electronics worth 40% as well. These papers cover 2 years of work. The final 20% of the marks consist of coursework projects, the first of which is microcontroller system, which is in the assembler language program. And that's 6%. The major coursework, worth 14%, is electronic systems. These are internally marked and moderated by the exam board.
What are electronics results like? 2019 was the first year through for this reform syllabus. All students passed at grades D or above. 19 from 25 students gained C to A star grades. 2 students got A star grades. We anticipate similar or better results for 2020.
how to succeed in electronics. As with any subject, arrive on time, ask when you need to, attend consistently, believe in yourself, come equipped, learn from your mistakes, meet deadlines, show you're working, solve problems, and particularly for electronics, check your circuits.
Say a little bit more about some of these, about asking when you need to. Joining in with a class discussion will help you develop your confidence. But if you find this intimidating, there will be small group work where you can chat to two or three others. Please catch your teacher on a one-to-one if you need to, and email if there isn't time for a one-to-one chat. We will reply to email requests promptly. If you find the work difficult and I haven't understood in class, then we can arrange some one-to-one time with a teacher or possibly with a second year mentor.
Above all, don't give up. If you haven't grasped a section of the work the first time you meet it, if you have it explained to you a different way or by a different person, you should eventually get there. During the course, it will often be indicated when sections of work are particularly challenging, i.e. A or A star grade standard. It would be better to concentrate on the more straightforward sections to ensure you get at least a C, for example.
About solving problems. Answering questions for the exam, succeeding in practical work including investigations, and doing electronics in reality, i.e. as a hobby or for a living, means you have to use what you know to tackle unfamiliar situations. For example, here is a circuit you haven't met before and what it's supposed to do, but part of it is wrong. Look at it, say what is wrong, and explain how to make it function correctly. Your teacher can give examples of this, and you can gain the skills you need by attempting solutions.